answers the longing of every human heart for love. We're the Church of a Love Story.
That was awesome.
Real Life Catholic with Chris Stefanik. Tonight at 11 p.m. Eastern on EWTN.
EWTN. Live truth. Live Catholic.
Family, a prayer that we pray together is a powerful prayer. So please pray together with me our EWTN family prayer. Today we pray for an end to violence. Almighty God, we worship you, our Father. We pray for an end to violence in our cities, and for the conversion of those involved in street gangs and organized crime. Help them, O Lord, to recognize the dignity of every human person, and to remember that we will all have to render an account to you, who are the just judge, who can neither deceive nor be deceived. Restore peace to our streets, and bring an end to the cycle of poverty and violence. Amen.
Behold the Lamb of God, who takes away the sins of the world. Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
we welcome Father Sebastian, who is from Kerala, India. He is the Carmelite Provincial of the Malabar Province, and he'll be our homilist this morning, and will tell us some things about the church in India. Brethren, let us acknowledge our sins, and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. I confess to Almighty God, and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore I ask Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Thank you.
let us pray. Almighty ever-living God, who while the Blessed Virgin Mary was carrying your Son in her womb, inspired her to visit Elizabeth, grant us, we pray, that faithful to the promptings of the Spirit, we may magnify your greatness with the Virgin Mary at all times. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. Brothers and sisters, let love be sincere. Hate what is evil. Hold on to what is good. Love one another with mutual affection. Anticipate one another in showing honor. Do not grow slack in zeal. Be fervent in spirit. Serve the Lord. Rejoice in hope. Endure in affliction. Persevere in prayer. Contribute to the needs of the holy ones. Exercise hospitality. Bless those who persecute you. Bless and do not curse them. Rejoice with those who rejoice. Weep with those who weep. Have the same regard for one another. Do not be haughty, but associate with the lowly. Do not be wise in your own estimation. Verbum Domini.
spoken to you by the Lord would be fulfilled.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to St. Luke. Mary set out and traveled to the hill country in haste, to a town of Judea, where she entered the house of Zechariah and greeted Elizabeth. When Elizabeth heard Mary's greeting, the infant leaped in her womb, and Elizabeth, filled with the Holy Spirit, cried out in a loud voice and said, "Most blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb. And how does this happen to me, that the mother of my Lord should come to me? For at the moment the sound of your greeting reached my ears, the infant in my womb leaped for joy. Blessed are you who believed that what was spoken to you by the Lord would be fulfilled." And Mary said, "My soul proclaims the greatness of the Lord. My spirit rejoices in God my Savior, for he has looked with favor on his lonely servant. From this day all generations will call me blessed. The Almighty has done great things for me, and holy is his name. He has mercy on those who fear him in every generation. He has shown the strength of his hand. He has scattered the proud in their conceit. He has cast down the mighty from their thrones. He has lifted the lowly. He has filled the hungry with good things, and the rich he has sent away empty. He has come to the help of his servant Israel, for he has remembered his promise of mercy, the promise he made to our fathers, to Abraham and his children forever." Mary remained with her about 3 months and then returned to her home. The Gospel of the Lord. Dear brothers and sisters in Christ, I am really happy to be here today to give this homily. As Father Joseph said, I was recommended to be speaking, sharing something about India and how we live our faith in India. So today is a most beautiful day, 31st of May, the conclusion of the May devotion, the devotion to Our Lady, and also the Feast of the Visitation. And we are really happy to celebrate this feast in this Franciscan house, because this Feast of the Visitation was first introduced in the church in the chapter of the Franciscans in 1263, recommended by Saint Bonaventure. But it came to the Universal Church later in 1389 by Pope Boniface IX. And the reason was, at that time, the Church was facing the Western Schism. We have heard about the papacy in Rome and papacy in Avignon. At that time, Pope wanted the real grace of God in the Church and real unity. And for that reason, Pope Boniface introduced this feast to the Universal Church. And miraculously, after a few years, unity was brought to the Church. So as we are celebrating this Feast of the Visitation today, it's a time of blessing for us, it's a time of grace for us. And so, in this Gospel today, we have read how Mary was praising the Lord, the Magnificat. and to share about the way faith is lived in India, I thought I will take this particular one particular word, Mary comparing the rich and the poor. And today's church, in comparison to the past, is poor. We all remember, we all speak about the good old days in the church, when all the churches were full, when all were practicing people. But now, we are all worried, wherever we go, we hear people sharing about those good old days, comparing that with the present day. Today we see many empty churches. We experience a lot of setbacks. We see government policies against the church. And so this always, with all this, we are prompted to say that we are poor today. The church is poor today. So in this context, I want to bring your attention to another world where faith is lived differently, that is in India. So why I am here today is Victoria McLean, who is here. She was in India with our brothers, teaching our brothers for about 3 months. And she has seen how faith is lived there, both in the families and in the churches outside. So I wanted just to say one aspect today, that is about how we live our faith in families. And especially today's feast, the Feast of the Visitation, is all about family. Mary visiting with her child in the womb, her cousin Elizabeth, who has child in her womb. One person, child, not even born, unborn child on the one side, and an old lady. Two ends of family life. And this Mary visiting and supporting Elizabeth in her need, that certainly speaks about family atmosphere. How we have to take care on the one side, the children, even the unborn, and the older people. And in our place, especially I am coming from Kerala, one of the most important, most beautiful aspects of Christian life is the way we lead our prayer life. And every day in families, we have family prayer. We call it either family prayer or evening prayer. It is synonymously used. And we have, all of us will be gathering in the family room, usually in the sitting room, the living room. And we all say in the evening this prayer. Certainly, major part would be, one is Angelus, is invariable part of the evening prayer, and then the Holy Rosary. And there will be also other prayers, especially praying for those people who are departed, and certainly from their family, and sometimes other devotions, especially in the context of the charismatic retreats that are there. So we have added many other prayers, but invariably, the Angelus and Rosary, all of us pray together. And after the prayer, we all give, say, praise to be Jesus Christ to each member, beginning to the eldest, to the youngest one. Each one greet each other with praise to be Jesus Christ. And this is the way this has become an integral part, an invariable part of our prayer life or faith life. I would say that there is no family in India, especially in my state of Kerala, where this is not happening. And I always believe that this has a lot to contribute to our Christian faith. And Kerala is a state which provides priests and religious to many, many dioceses all over the world, and I am certain that even our diocese here, there should be people, priests from Kerala working in this diocese. And this has to be attributed, the reason why we have a great abundance of good priests and religious and people who are practicing Catholic life in their life. It's the fact that this is very much nurtured in the family, and this is something to be continued, and I'm not lamenting or boasting about what is happening in one place or the other, but life, faith is lived differently in many places, and some have proven to be more effective than the others. So I would always say we have to come back to the older days, and as the saying goes, virtue begins at home, and the Christian faith is lived, has to be lived in our family circumstances, and then it goes to the church and to the society. And tomorrow, if I am getting an occasion, I would certainly be speaking about how we live our faith in the parishes, in our context. So I am very happy to share this experience in India in the context of a family atmosphere. And this EWTN family network is all connected with family. So this feast is connected with Franciscans in the beginning, as they are the first ones to introduce this feast to the church. And then the feast of the family, and how faith is nurtured or born, nurtured and flourished in family context. And also this network, which is very much devoted to family. So now, let us pray to the intercession, for the intercession of Blessed Mary, that we all experience this special gift of God's blessings, which this feast of the Visitation has. Elizabeth, in her old age, and John the Baptist, when he was in the womb of his mother, received the blessing of this feast of the Visitation. We too will receive the feast of the Visitation. So let us now pray for the intercession of our Blessed Mother, that we all receive this grace, and that we are able to respect everybody, especially in our family context, and that grace is given to us, that we go back to our families and nurture our faith from the family, so that our little children, those from their unborn stage, are living in the circumstances of faith, in the atmosphere of faith, and the Lord bless us in our homes and in our families. May God be with us.
From all eternity, God chose Mary to be the mother of Jesus and our mother. With her, let us offer the following prayers to the Father.
That our Holy Father and his fellow bishops may find us attuned to their call to follow with faith and courage the path on which the Good Shepherd leads. We pray to the Lord. For our brothers and sisters imprisoned or suffering, for the name of Christ, that the Lord be present to them and give them the freedom of the children of God. We pray to the Lord. That God, who commands us not to kill, may strengthen the efforts of all his people to end abortion. We pray to the Lord. That many young men and women will open their hearts to serving the Lord in the priesthood and the consecrated life. We pray to the Lord. For the faithful departed, that they may soon be with the Lord in paradise. We pray to the Lord.
We pray for a renewal of devotion and family life, for healing of family life, especially in our Western world, that on this Feast of the Visitation, Mary may obtain many graces for our families. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
O God, you sent the Blessed Virgin Mary to visit her cousin Elizabeth and to share with her the joy of your son's coming. Give us the courage to always fulfill your holy will, so that we may glorify you with her for all eternity. Through Christ our Lord. Pray, brethren, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May yours and the sacrifice of your hands, for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the cause of
all
eternity.
May our offering of this saving sacrifice be acceptable to your majesty, O Lord. As you are pleased to accept the charity of the most blessed mother of your only begotten Son, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
Dominus vobiscum. Sacramus Domino Deo Nostro. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, to praise your mighty deeds in the exaltation of all the saints, and especially as we celebrate the memory of the Blessed Virgin Mary, to proclaim your kindness as we echo her thankful hymn of praise. For truly, even to her sins, you have done great things and extended your abundant mercy from age to age. When you looked on the lowliness of your handmaid, you gave us through her the author of our salvation, your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Through him the host of angels adores your majesty and rejoices in your presence forever. May our voices, we pray, join with theirs in one chorus of exultant praise, as we acclaim.
Sanctus, Sanctus, Sanctus.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." Mysterium Fidei. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Robert, our Bishop, and all the clergy.
Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with angels and her spouse, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Recepti salutaribus monici et divina institutione formati, audemus dicere.
Pater noster, qui es in celis, sanctificetur nomen tuum, adveniat regnum tuum, fiat voluntas tua, sicut in cielo et in terra. Pane nostrum quotidianum,
nobis Domine ab omnibus malis, la propitius pacem in diebus nostris, odope misericordiae tui adiuti, et a peccato simus semper liberi, et ab omni perturbatione securi, expectantes beatam spem, et adventum salvatoris nostri Jesu Christi. Domine Jesu Christe, quid existi apostolis tuis, pacem relinquo vobis, pacem meum do vobis, ne despicias peccata nostra, sed fidem ecclesiae tue, eam quae secunda voluntatem tuam pacificare puerunare degneris, qui vivis et regnas in saecula saeculorum.
Amen.
Pax Domini sit semper vobiscum.
Et tu
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be
All generations will call me blessed, for he who is mighty has done great things for me, and holy is his name.
To those who cannot now receive Jesus in the Blessed Sacrament, we offer the following prayer. Most loving Jesus, I adore thee with a lively faith, who art present in this sacrament by virtue of thine infinite power, wisdom, and goodness. All my hope is in thee. I love thee, O Lord, with all my heart, who has so loved me, and therefore I desire to receive thee now spiritually. Come therefore, O Lord, to me in spirit, and heal my sinful soul. Feed me, for I am hungry. Strengthen me, for I am weak. Enliven and sanctify me with thy sacred body and blood. Deliver me from all sin, and make me always obedient to thy commandments. And let me never be separated from thee, my Saviour, who with the Father and the Holy Spirit livest and reignest, one God, world without end. Amen.
And
Let us pray. May your church proclaim your greatness, O God, for you have done great things for your faithful. And as St. John the Baptist leapt with joy when he first sensed the hidden presence of Christ, so may your church rejoice to receive in this sacrament the same ever-living Lord, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
Thank you, Father Sebastian, for your words today and telling us about the fervent faith in India. We pray that we'll take that to heart to bring prayer back into our family life. And we are blessed in this diocese to have, I think, 13 priests from India who help with the mission here in this still mission diocese of Birmingham, Alabama. We look forward to your words tomorrow about the parish life in Kerala. Dominus vobiscum.
Deus in
eulo. Benedicat vos omnipotens Deus, Pater et Filius et Spiritus Sanctus.
Thank you.
If any man's work is burned up, he will suffer loss, though he himself will be saved, but only as through fire. 1 Corinthians chapter 3, verse 15.
A ciborium is a chalice-like container with a lid, used to hold the host for communion. Consecrated hosts reserved in the tabernacle are kept in a ciborium. It is made of metal, and the interior must be lined with gold. A silk veil is placed over the ciborium when covered.
EWTN. Live truth. Live Catholic.
One of the greatest blessings you can bring to your spiritual life.
Yeah, I can attest to that in my own personal life. I prayed the rosary, but I didn't consider it to be a particularly enjoyable prayer, may I put it that way. But during a time of crisis in my life, it took on a new significance and value for me. And the fact of the matter is now that the rosary, it really does form the heart of my prayer time. Mm-hmm. Everything comes from the rosary in my prayer time. Mm-hmm. So that's the journey the Lord has me on at the present moment. Mm-hmm. That changes. The liturgy of the hour is beautiful too. Mm-hmm. But there's something about, I sit down, I feel like, okay, so I'm with my mother now. Yeah. And we approach her son together, and she tells me little things about him, and those kinds of things. Because we allow ourselves to enter into that mystery, and to let that mystery enter into us. And I am so happy that you have allowed us to have the opportunity to spend this time with you today. We have the question and answer portion of our live show tomorrow, which is very exciting. But I do want to thank you from the bottom of my heart for all that you're doing, Father Calloway. And so very, very happy that you are a priest of God who is unabashedly in love with Our Lady and loves to talk about her and to promote her very, very solid and efficacious spiritual weapon, the rosary.
Thank you, John. God bless you.
Well, you're so welcome. It's my pleasure. So we want to send you out to EWTNRC.com to get a copy of Father's book. It is a wonderful book. You will not be sorry. This is a book that belongs on your bookshelf and the bookshelves of everybody that you love. So buy a bunch of them. It is Champions of the Rosary, the History and Heroes of this Spiritual Weapon, available for you there, as are all of the programs in this series and the Warrior Rosary. Bye-bye now. Thank you.